Sorry, brother. I'm still stuck in what I heard back there. Zeus was your father?
Not now. We should focus on getting out of hell.
And with that, I cannot argue. I'll just contemplate that little nugget in silence, then.
Ha! happened to your boy already?
Don't worry, kids are tough. When I was his age, I cut my own head clean off, and I'm none the worse for wear.
Shouldn't delay, brother. It's straight back to Midgard with that heart. Your father was Zeus? I finally understand. I'm dangling from the hip of the bloody ghost of Sparta.
Do not call me that.
Oh, don't mistake me, brother. From what I heard, the Pantheon had it coming. But it's still a bit to take in. I knew you hate gods, but you really can't stay away from them, can you?
You must say nothing to the boy. He must never know.
Bollocks, brother. Respectfully, bollocks. He has to know. He'll never be whole without the truth. Look, I get it. You hate the gods. All gods. It's no accident that includes yourself. And it includes your boy. You see that? He feels that. He can't help what he is. He can't begin to help it because you haven't even told him. It's all connected, man.
You will tell him nothing.
Very well.
So you know that shortcut between realms?
Well, I made it better. Or I might have broke it.
We use that.
I know you do. So I took a few gusts from them winds of hell and made it so it ain't just one way. Now you can use it to travel to and from. If I didn't break it.
Then we can take it to Freya.
There's an idea, brother.
Might be some keys to sort out, but you'll make it.
Just go, brother. Gentlemen certainly know how to get around. Well, this isn't right. But close enough. He did say there were kinks.
We must hurry.
You have it.
Yes.
Back of your hand.
You're still ill.
I can break the fever, but to heal...
He must know the truth of what he is.
Yes.
not so simple.
Help me prop him up. Did I tell you that I have a son, too? It's been forever since I last saw him. At his birth, the runes foretold a needless death. The babe in my arms was so small, so helpless. I knew right then I would do anything to protect him, no matter the sacrifice. Of course, everything I did for myself. I let my needs, my fears, come before what he needed. And I couldn't see his resentment until it was too late. Don't make the same mistake. Have faith in him. I know the truth isn't simple, but nothing is when it involves your child.
It is a curse. The boy has been cursed.
Don't leave without me.
I will not.
I'm better now.
I see that. Is he well enough to travel?
For now.
It won't happen again. I promise.
You see that it does not. Forget this.
Thanks.
Your father did the heavy lifting. You should stay, recover.
You have done enough.
You know my door is always open to you.
That's Venon, isn't it?
You figured that out, did you?
Well, the window looks like Bifrost Crystal, and I know that's not what's on the other side of the wall. And, well, it makes you sad.
You are wise for one so young. Yes, this is a window to a home I left long ago, but it is only a view.
The thing that happened to you in Alfheim, you can't leave Midgard, can you?
A gift from my former husband upon our separation.
Why would Odin trap you in Midgard?
Petty cruelty would be reason enough for him, but as with all his rash decisions, he's driven by fear. The Vanir were the greatest threat to the Aesir until our marriage brokered peace. Many of the Vanir now think I betrayed them, the fruits of my sacrifice. To be hated by my own kind, to trap me here, is to ensure I can never make it right.
So I was wondering, why do you live under a turtle?
He was my first friend here in Midgard. He offered me shelter, and in return I provide him with protection against the evils of the forest.
Golden boar, giant turtle? You sure have some interesting friends.
Now then, before Modi so rudely interrupted us, we were just about to explore Tyr's vault.
Yes, to find the Black Rune. Boy, do you know the way from here?
Oh, I don't know.
Sure you do, lad. We need a boat.
I don't know. I guess we need a boat.
Okay then. Ah, see? The boat washed ashore. Someone did call a serpent earlier.
Get in. I will pull. You are quiet. Are you not better?
I guess.
I know you overheard my talk with Freya. You think you understand, but you do not. Why do you say nothing?
You said I was cursed. You think I'm weak because I'm not like you. I know I was never what you wanted. But after all this, I thought maybe things were different.
You do not know everything, boy.
No. But at least I know the truth now.
The truth. The truth. I am a god, boy. From another land far from here. When I came to these shores, I chose to live as a man. But the truth is, I was born a god, and so were you. Boy, have you nothing to say?
Can I turn into an animal?
Can you turn into an animal? No, I do not think so.
I'm a god. Mother knew? She was a god too?
No. She was mortal, but she knew my true nature.
I'm a god. Why did you wait so long to tell me?
I had hoped to spare you. Being a god, it can be a lifetime of anguish and tragedy. That is the curse.
What sorts of things can I do? Can I fly? Turn invisible? I don't feel like a god.
I do not know the reach of your godhood. But over time, we will learn.
You sure I can't turn into a wolf?
You are welcome to surprise me.
Is this why you hear voices sometimes? Are you sure you've never heard any?
Not as you do.
That's no surprise. Every god is unique.
So maybe I won't get strong like father, but I'll have abilities all my own.
You already do, laddie. Your faculty for language is extraordinary for one so young. Time alone will tell what else you'll become capable of.
So you knew all along?
I did, lad. But I've known more than my share of gods.
Me too, apparently. I wonder who else knew I was a god. Freya, for sure. Brock and Sindri?
They do not need to know.
Baldur! Does he know? Is that why he's after us? Do you know him from before?
The day of your mother's funeral was the first I ever saw Baldur. That is the truth.
Hey, we don't have to go right back to Tirzval, do we? I mean, we're God. We can do whatever we want, right? What do you really feel like doing right now?
I will show you.
What can you tell me about that giant lady with the bow?
And we'll pick this up later.
Oh, letter here and there, but we need the rest of the language disc.
Boy.
Okay, that's going in the journal.
Thank you.
Treasure map. If you remember, I started a doozy of a story earlier.
It was about Skadi, Queen of the Hunt. She was called Skadi, Queen of the Hunt. Her father was Thjotsi, who could take the shape of any wild creature, and taught Skadi how to hunt them all. From the ribs of pack beasts, she fashioned second feet, allowing her to glide upon the snow so no animal could evade her. She became a huntress beyond compare, even to any god. Odin himself wanted her for his bride, believing she would bear him strong sons. But she spurned his affections, and for that insult, Odin vowed revenge.
And we'll pick this up later.
It was about the Queen of the Hunt, who rejected Odin's advances. About revenge.
And we'll pick this up later. Story I started earlier.
It was about the Queen of the Hunt, who rejected Odin's romantic advances, causing him to vow revenge. It was put forth that the Aesir were plagued by an eagle who would steal the precious golden apples of Idun. Not even the finest archer among the gods could bring it down. Odin knew that Skadi could not resist the temptation to prove herself superior, and so she joined the hunt. Skadi tracked the eagle as it flew where she alone could glide, and loosed an arrow from her unerring bow. When she collected her quarry, she found no eagle at all. but her own father, poor Thiotsi, slain by his own daughter. She was overcome with grief and shame, for there is nothing nature so reviles as a child who kills their parent. Skadi succumbed to her fate as winter's blanket fell, holding her father as the mountain held her in an embrace to last eternity.
Well, that was sad.
Aye. There aren't many happy endings for the giants, I'm afraid.
Thank you. Thank you. Behind you! Look out!
Without the whole cipher.
Question. If Ymir was the first giant, where did he come from?
In the beginning, there was Ganungagap, a great boy. There were no realms yet, only primordial forces. There was fire, and there was ice. And there in the void, they met and produced. But I can just tell you this story later.
Right then. We were in the middle of a story, weren't we?
Regarding Ymir. Primordial fire and ice met in the great void, producing water.
Water?
More than water. The mystic lifeblood of something entirely new. From this water, Ymir took form and became a being of pure creation and chaos, mother and father to all that came after.
Even the Aesir?
Aye. Every god, man, and beast came first from Ymir's flesh. Though it was the Aesir who thought themselves so superior that they should hold dominion over the rest of creation. It was Odin who took arms against his creator and spilled Ymir's lifeblood with his spear. A necessary evil, he would say, to bring order to the realms. With Ymir's torn flesh, Odin would fashion the realm of Midgard for his own. Called himself All-Father, as if he was the creator, and not the creator's destroyer. The small, covetous tyrant!
The mirror?
Huh? Oh, sorry, my boy. You know, I think it best we just end it there, actually.
Once you retrieve the whetstone, please take utmost care while handling it. It is a priceless relic, after all.
I'm feeling creative today. Oh, we can't forget you. Ah. Something else for you then? Be seeing ya!
I still can't believe a son would kill his own father. That's crazy, right? I know, we only got one side of the story. But come on, his own father? I mean, I get angry at you sometimes, but...
Do you?
I mean, sometimes, yeah. A little. But I've never stabbed you in the back.
No. I imagine not.
This clan really didn't want anyone coming in. How are we supposed to get through?
There must be a way to lift the gate.
Maybe with the big water wheel.
My thought as well.
Focus up!
Oh, I guess sometimes when you don't think I can do something, but I can.
It is not always easy to know what.
It's okay. I get it. I'm little. Where's that whetstone, I wonder?
Whoa! Not a fan.
Quiet,
This is the sun.
That ghost sun? How do you know?
The sigil. It matches the dagger we found in his father's back. He stood his ground, but it was not enough.
They betrayed him.
Betrayal begets betrayal. My guess, the young one murdering his dad didn't sit well with the others.
He thought himself ready to lead. It cost him his life.
I guess.
Look there, lad. By his feet.
The whetstone!
Yes. They used it to smash his face in.
They did? Ew.
Ready us! Oh, boy.
Weavers have very specific priorities. If it's not shiny and you can't eat or drink it, might as well use it as a blunt object.
Is over. Look here.
Yes, sir. There's a scroll here. It belonged to the sun. Wow, this goes on and on. Father, forgive me. Filled with remorse. Forget my actions.
Had he thought before taking action, there would be no need for regret, yes?
Yeah. Maybe we should bring this to his father. Back at the storeroom.
Boy.
Sir.
Another map. Great.
Read it.
This says, false leader. I've seen it written all over this place.
Dock the boat here.
Ed, you are full of stories. When will you tell one that entertains?
I beg your pardon?
He just insulted you.
Yeah, I got that. So you want a cork up, do you? Very well, my brothers. I'll
tell you.
We found your whetstone.
Oh, wonderful!
This staining is unusual.
The Reavers used it to smash another Reaver's face in.
Oh, wonderful. I can't wait to test out the new whetstone. It may not look like much, but it's practically humming with magic. I've needed a new one after my brother borrowed the last one. I saw him spit on it.
To lube it up!
He said. I didn't ask for it back.
Story I started earlier.
I was to tell you the story of Hrungnir the Brawler. The real story.
There was a huge battle, right? His shrine had him in the middle, fighting off Aesir.
A pretty story, but
no.
Hrungnir, you see, was born with neither head nor heart. So the giants had to complete him with stone. He was strong, to be sure, but also a perfect simpleton. Odin met him wandering in Midgard one day. Found him so amusing, so harmless, so gullible, that he invites him back to his palace in Asgard. There he gives Hrungnir his fill of mead, and goads him into all manner of boasts and antics, all for the amusement of the court. But I can just tell you this story later. We were in the middle of a story, weren't we? Odin had invited Hrungnir to his palace in Asgard, getting the simple giant drunk to amuse the court. I was there. I saw the Aesir laugh as Hrungnir leapt upon his shield and swore he'd kill us all and take our womenfolk back to Jotunheim. But I can just tell you this story later. Right then. We were in the middle of a story, weren't we? Odin had invited Hrungnir to his palace in Asgard, getting the simple giant drunk to amuse the court. Then Thor shows up. And does he laugh? Oh, no. Thor takes one look at the drunken stone buffoon and brings down Mjolnir on his head so hard that he's got chunks of Hunir in his own skull to this day. Thor is so startled by the faceful of rock, he doesn't notice Hunir's body topple right onto him with a sickening crunch. And again, the roars of laughter echo through the palace halls.
That's an awful story, Mjolnir. Nothing like the one's mother told me.
Might that be a lesson, my son? The truth is seldom so pretty as myth and legend.
To the city?
I'm not entirely sure, lad. It was abandoned long before Jormungandr came to town and flooded the place.
I wonder what it was like to live here.
Mm-hmm.